السلام عليكم نينجاز. Peace be upon you. Ni hao. Welcome back. Dobrodošli nazad. Today we're going to talk about the latest Redmi Note 11 Pro Plus smartphone and obviously the Redmi Note 11 Pro in comparison to the Poco F3, the Redmi K40 in my hands, guys. What you're going to buy it? Obviously, the Redmi Note 11 Pro just came out. It's only available in China in Chinese stores. Nobody yet can obviously purchase it online, so you can ship it to yourself in Europe or USA, it depends where you live. But guys, what I want to tell you about, obviously talk about what you should choose, what you're gonna buy. Is it maybe a smart move to buy the Redmi Note 11 Pro right now when you have something like Poco F3 for $350, which Redmi Note 11 Pro is also selling around $350, while the Redmi Note 11 Pro Plus is around $40 more expensive, guys. And I think Redmi Note 11 Pro on flash sale will be selling for $320. Nevertheless, the Poco F3 is the best alternative and is the best competitor. I don't think you're gonna find any other smartphone that you guys will look in the comparison list. Probably gonna immediately put the Poco F3 Pro in your hands. This is such a still the best deal of all time. It's crazy how good this device. Yes, maybe it's a, right now, let's call it disclaimer on a mark there that it's an older device, but how in the heck it's an older? It still has an amazing flagship chip, the Snapdragon 870, and two or three major points, which obviously is going to be a letdown for you for the Redmi Note 11 Pro Plus, guys, and the Redmi Note 11 Pro, that it comes with the Dimensity 920. So this Dimensity 920, guys, probably I'm going to share a few more of the clip videos in this video itself, so you can see by yourself more details about the Antutu scores and everything. The Dimensity 920, unfortunately, guys, it's not even close to the Snapdragon 870. It's around 50% slower, I would say, like that. The Redmi K40 12GB, the Poco F3, scores around 700,000 points, almost 700,000 points, guys, which is, again, it's a huge, huge difference, while the Dimensity 920 Redmi Note 11 Pro series score maximum, so far what I'm seeing, the average score is 450,000. I even saw somebody scored 490,000, and somebody even scored 430,000, yeah. So yes, guys, the letdown again, maybe it is the storage, of course, the speed of the storage regarding the ROM. Both of them come with the 128GB, but the Redmi Note 11 Pro will have the UFS 2 type, while the Poco F3 has the UFS 3 type, guys. So again, that's also a big, big difference. What can I tell you also? It seems that the Poco F3 will have a slightly better display regarding the viewing angles and the brightness. It seems that the Poco F3 is slightly brighter display. This is an AMOLED 120Hz screen, the E4 AMOLED type, guys, while the Redmi Note 11 Pro, I think maybe it's E2 or E3, but so far we don't have 100% confirmed news about this one. So just have that in mind, that probably also the Redmi Note 11 Pro will not get a better screen than the which you actually already have on the Poco F3 devices / Redmi K40. What you do get with the Redmi Note 11 Pro is an updated spec, so you have a 108 megapixel camera sensor. With the Poco F3, you don't have that, guys. You have 120 watts fast charging speeds with the Redmi Note 11 Pro, and that's the first mid-range smartphone, let's just say under $400, that has this feature. Not any single smartphone so far had this kind of speed, guys. 4500 mAh battery. The Poco F3 has it's a much, much smaller battery speeds here regarding the charging. It's gonna take around 3 to 4 times more to charge this device, guys. I mean, 3 to 4 times, it's a huge difference. Nevertheless, both of them have stereo speakers, guys, while the Redmi Note 11 Pro, it seems that also will come with the headphone jack and SD card expansion, but regarding the SD card expansion, not yet 100% confirmed. So yes, guys, like I told you right now, this is a short video, just discussion with you. What do you think? What would you obviously purchase by yourself? Is it smart right now to buy the Redmi Note 11 Pro Plus when you have the Poco F3, the Redmi K40? I will leave the buying links in the description. Yes, like I said here, the Redmi K40 Poco F3 maybe doesn't have a 108 megapixel sensor, maybe doesn't have a 120 watts fast charging technology, but still, it does have a really good camera, 48 megapixel sensor. sensor on the back, guys, for this price tag, 48 megapixel sensor, and also it has a good battery life, 4500, with a good decent charging speeds for this price tag. But again, yes, the Redmi again done a huge shocking obviously announcements and releases with this Redmi Note 11 Pro series, that they included such a high premium flagship specs in a device which is selling around $350. Again, it's crazy, man, it's crazy. So yes, guys, please make sure to leave in the comment section your thoughts, share this video, like it, and see you until next time. Remember, I will leave the buying links in the description. For now, what I would say to you, again, it's your money, guys, it's your money, but in my opinion, I think that what I would say to you is the letdown, the big reason why we're not gonna get the Redmi Note 11 Pro. If you are into the gaming in emulators, especially emulators, emulation scene, you will probably skip the Dimensity 920, the Snapdragon 870, it will be easily 2 to 3 times more faster in those heavy demanding emulators, guys. So just have that in mind. This is probably the number one reason. Everything about Redmi Note 11 Pro, I love it, seriously, it's an amazing device. But for, let's just say, a power users and emulators, somebody who's just leaning mainly about the gaming side, you should go with the Poco F3, guys. You should go with the Poco F3, trust me. You go with the Poco F3, you're not gonna make a mistake. That's why I'm gonna leave you with the buying links in the description. And I can't wait to get the Redmi Note 11 Pro by myself to test it, and obviously to see what we can do, how the camera works, the battery, the display, everything, the performance. Because Dimensity 920 is a new chip, and I would love to test new chip in different tests. Anyway, thank you for watching this video. Have a great day. Salam.